Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are on the way to discover how to run Mega Man X DiVE Mobile on PC. Now you can watch it on screen. It takes almost no time to efficiently download and install Mega Man X DiVE Mobile so that we can enjoy playing this game on the Windows desktop or laptop with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So without further ado, let's go my friends. First of all mates, to get started we have to launch our main web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type it, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed right here on our website of Usitility, at which we find here a precise explanation on how you can download and install Mega Man X DiVE Mobile on PC. We scroll down a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Mega Man X DiVE Mobile on PC. As you can discover here, we get a number of pros of preferring the emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Mega Man X DiVE Mobile by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on this button, and the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do is to launch the installer, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the computer. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to see the installer considerably better. The installer is very simple. It consists of two possibilities, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We basically simply click on it. And we observe that we have here the path where in fact the emulator can be set up. If we choose to change this directory, we are required to click on the browse option. And now we decide on another folder and install the emulator specifically where we like. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. I simply click on back. And I simply click on install. Now, there it is. The installation starts and it's going to progress in the download of those megabytes that are visible on the computer screen. Once you download it, it could possibly be more or less MB. The data transfer rate might go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, based on your type of access to the web and according to the performance of the emulator servers. Now they are running superbly fast. The download is finished, and so now it continues with the setup procedure. The installation will require more or less time primarily based on the power of your laptop or computer. The more powerful it actually is, the faster the setup time and or vice versa. If we add together the download and setup stage, it might take quite a while, so show patience. It is by now finished on my side. Now, the emulator has been launched immediately. As you can see, down here, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right, and once it attains the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. In fact, the emulator was already launched, here for the very first time. Before we continue, as you can observe, it has created two app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the only one we are concerned with. Anytime we have to launch Mega Man X DiVE Mobile on our laptop or computer, we twice click this specific app icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon is not about multiplayer or even nearly anything like this. In reality, it is a software icon that we will most certainly never start using. Let's perform the next step, that is a must-have, and this is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play is launched. Here we must log on. Now as soon as we are there, we must absolutely conduct the next step, which is absolutely mandatory. So we just click on Sign In. Now it says, checking info. It can in some cases get stopped at checking info, that's why it doesn't move ahead. If so, you could try to log in after a number of hours and it will surely most likely be repaired. Now we will enter our email and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email and its associated password. For example, you can utilize the same email you use at this time in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to type in my info and I will go back immediately after I have completed it. That's it, details entered. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We will agree to them all by pressing, I agree. Next, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected and it'll create a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play is launched by default and immediately. To set up the application, we must go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon marked green colored. Now that we are watching the desktop of the Android emulator, we can see that we find right here the install game button. We then click on the button. Here we get the game. Let's quickly mouse click now on the install option that I'm displaying now in green color. And it will begin the installation. At present it is going to install the game. It usually takes a bit of time or it may just be extremely fast. That all is going to depend on our internet access. This has actually ended setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting this button I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can launch Mega Man X DiVE Mobile for the first time. Let's mouse click on the My Games option just above. We are by now on the emulator desktop, then we're on the way to simply click that new Mega Man X DiVE Mobile icon which was created. The video game is launched for the very first time. Here we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume of this emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is the first one. We just click on that app icon that I am actually mentioning in green color. And the screen is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If we really want to enjoy the video game using all the screen, we click this particular icon. And we'd already be experiencing the gameplay in 100% screen setting. To leave the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we would likely already end up being in standard display screen mode. Now I am starting to show you the computer keyboard mapping and that is certainly quite appealing. This step we will be in a position to utilize the game app a lot more easily. The first task is to click this application icon. It's now time to make the required setups. I most certainly will keep the default configuration, though if you want to adjust it, you may well do it now without any problem. As you can see, the emulator is totally in our language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is started in the wrong language, as an example, in Mandarin. And to set it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And here within additional configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We should decide on the language we like, German, Chinese, and so on. Once the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the video game, next time we start it, would of course be in the preferred language. Now, there's another detail that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail indicating that a different device has been associated with our Google account. It definitely will question us if we are the individuals who have associated with that device. That's right, we really should not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is behaving like an Android electronic device. And to discover which device is being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we go here to the model option. And right here we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the training. I hope that you appreciated it, particularly that you found it interesting. If so, allow it a great thumb up, subscribe, and any feedback, requests or suggestions, put them in the comment area below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every once in a while. You get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Check out any of those video tutorials that are showing up on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the future training videos. Bye.